Okay, so now what we will see? We will see how solubility is affected by the covalent character. So now what I am talking about is covalent character in ionic bond. Okay, what does that mean? See, no bond is 100% ionic. No bond is 100% ionic. Okay, what happens is every bond has some amount of covalent character. And how this is explained? This is explained by a rule, that is Fajan's rule. Okay, so this is explained by Fajan's rule of polarizability. Okay, so what is covalent character and how it develops? Let's see. Okay, so what you do is you take atoms and you form cations out of it, right? You take an atom and you form cations out of it. And you take an atom and you form anions out of it to form a ionic compound. Okay, so let's suppose there was an atom and it has some n number of protons in its nucleus, and surrounded by it there are some n number of electrons in different cells. Okay, so what you are doing is you are removing one electron. So what will happen? Z effective. That is effective nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge will increase. Okay, so what will happen? Effective nuclear charge on the electrons will increase because there are more number of protons than the electrons. So proton will pull the electrons more strongly, right? Nucleus will pull the electron cloud more strongly. So size will decrease, right? What will happen with the anions? If you add extra electrons, what will happen? Size will increase and Z effective will decrease. Okay, so anions, these cations get a tendency to attract the electron clouds, not only its own electron clouds but any other electron cloud which is present nearby. Okay, because of the greater number of protons in the nucleus, what will happen? The cations tend to attract the electron cloud which is present nearby to it. Okay, so let's say I am drawing, cation is smaller in size, anion is bigger in size. So let's say I am drawing a cation and a anion, right? So this is a cation and anion, so plus and minus. Okay, so this is the ideal case when no polarization has been happened, no polarization happened here, right? So what will happen? This cation will tend to pull the electron cloud which is present nearby. So if the when the anion comes closer to it, what happens is, this is your cation and this was your anion initially. Okay, but what will happen? This cation will attract the electron cloud, right? So it will get distorted. The anion will get, so anion's electron cloud will get distorted like this. Understand? So what will happen? There is some common reason, right? This is the reason where the electron cloud of the cation and anion is common to each other. Fine. So in ideal case, this drawing is wrong. See, what happens is these touch each other, right? So if I try to draw it again, forget this picture. This is your cation and this will be your anion touching each other, right? In most of the cases. So what will happen? This some distortion will be like this. And there will be some electron cloud which is being shared between the cation and the anion. And as we know, sharing of electron cloud is known as covalent bond. What happens is sharing of electron cloud is known as covalent bond. So it develops a covalent character. So that's how a molecule gets, this anion gets polarized, cation polarizes the anion and molecule gets, your compound, ionic compound gets covalent character. Okay. So this is fine. So now what are the factors that will affect this thing? Okay, see, when we talk about cations, we talk about polarizing power, something called polarizing power. This is for cations. That means what happens is cation will polarize the anion. So what is the polarizing power of the cation? So smaller is the size, greater is the electron density and greater is the tendency of the cation to polarize the anion, right? So smaller size and greater charge density unit, so high charge. Okay, so polarizing power is directly proportional to charge. So I am writing this as PP. Okay, see, polarizing power is directly proportional to charge and inversely proportional to the size. While when you talk about anions, you talk about, this is for cations, right? So when you talk about anions, you talk about a term which is called polarizability. So this is nothing but polarizability, right? So that means what is the ability of the anions to get polarized, to get distorted, right? To get deformed. Okay, so this will be directly proportional to the charge. See, because see, greater is the size, see, greater is the charge, greater is the size, greater is the size, that means greater is smaller is the pull of the nuclei to its outermost electrons, right? So when nuclei cannot pull the outermost electron very strongly, what will happen? Some other positive charge will pull it if it is present in the nearby. Okay, so it is directly proportional to the charge and directly proportional to the size. So polarizability is directly proportional to the charge and directly proportional to the size. Okay, so these set of rules are called the Fajan's rule. Okay, so what will happen to get a greater covalent character, what you need? So in summary, to get a greater covalent character, what you need? A small cation and large anion. Small cation and large anion to get the greater covalent, leads to the greater covalent for higher covalent character, right? So these set of rules where you need a small cation, large anion to get greater amount of covalent character is called the Fajan's rule. Okay, so that is how polarizability work. Now what we will see, we will see how this is related to the solubility of the ionic compounds that we are studying. Let us look at a few more examples. Okay, let us look at sodium, say fluoride, sodium chloride, sodium bromide and sodium iodide. Okay, now what about, what is the covalent character nature in these molecules? Okay, so because method is, now you should have, you will have like expertise in this thing, right? You must have expertise. So now ions, cations are same, so they have great same amount of polarizing power. What about polarizability? See, size is increasing in this direction, that means iodide anion is the most polarizable, right? So what will be the covalent character? Order is this, right? What will be the melting point order? This is covalent character order, right? What will be the melting point order? In this direction, right? Because as covalent character increases, melting point decreases. Okay, now let's talk about another example. So these are very easy to guess, no? If you know what is the reason behind this. Now if I ask you what, which of them will have a maximum amount of melting point, maximum melting point, because again anions are, cations are same, anions, you will have to look for the anions. Now this iodide ion again is the most polarizable because of the size, right? So this will be the covalent character. What will be the melting point order? Okay, another example, let's say HF, HBr, let me write first HCl, then HBr and then HI. Okay, what do you expect in these molecules? Again the same thing, because all the cations are same, so covalent character is this, melting point order is this. Okay, so all this is pretty simple. See, one thing is here is that
it has maximum amount of covalent character. That means this is most ionic, right? But that doesn't mean that it is the strongest acid. Actually, HI is the strongest acid. And reason behind that is this. Although it has the most amount of covalent character, it is significantly ionic. All of them are significantly ionic, right? Although it has the most amount of covalent character, but size of iodine is so big that it is easiest to break, right? So, whenever if I am asking you what will be the strongest acid, do not confuse it with the ionic character or covalent character, right? This will be still be the most acidic because iodine HI bond in hydrogen iodide breaks most easily, okay? Now, let's take another example. Okay, so here cations, anions, cations are same, anions are different and charges are different, right? So, it has say minus 4, it has say minus 3, it has say minus 2, it has say minus 1. So, now carbon has the most amount of the charge and we know polarizability is directly proportional to the charge present on the ion. So, it will have the greatest amount of polarizability. So, covalent character is this, and thus you can easily guess also because in methane bonding is covalent, in HF bonding is significantly ionic, right? So it will be the covalent character, and what will be the melting point order? Like this, okay? So these are some very easy examples, okay? And if you understand polarizing power and polarizability in a very simple manner, you can guess all these, okay? So now what I will like to tell you is a new concept. And that is called, so leave it here, something called pseudo gas, pseudo electronic configuration, okay, not gas but pseudo electronic configuration. Okay, pseudo inert, okay, pseudo inert gas electronic configuration, okay. What do I mean by this thing? Okay, let's discuss this with example. Let's discuss this with example of say copper and sodium, okay. Both I'll give 1 plus charge and in both I'll discuss UCl and NSC, okay. Now I would like to give you some information. See, radius of both the both of these cations are almost similar. So, this is 90 say 96 angstrom, this somewhere around 95 angstrom. So, almost similar, right? Radius is similar, charge is similar. So, they should have similar amount of polarizing power, right? So, they should polarize any anion in a similar fashion, okay? So, if I want to ask you the covalent character, which of them will have a greater amount of covalent character? Based on this information, what you will tell me? They should have same amount of covalent character. That means if I ask which of them will have a greater amount of melting point or something like that, you will tell me that both of them will have a same amount of melting point, right? But that does not happen. What happens is melting point for CuCl is 442 degrees Celsius, while melting point of NaCl is somewhere around 800 degrees Celsius. Okay? Why is this so? So, this suggests me that NaCl is more ionic than CuCl. Although we have same anions involved, we have cations which are similar in size and similar in charge. So, why is this happening? Okay. So, this has something to do with the electronic configuration of copper. Okay. Now, let's try to discuss this. See, copper has this orbital, right? Copper has d orbital. Okay, it has an electronic configuration of what? So, if I talk about electronic configuration of copper, it should be 3s2, 3p6, 4s1 and 3d10. Okay, if I remove one electron or if I form copper plus, it becomes 3s2, 3p6, 3d10. Okay, so this you know how to write it, right? What I am going to tell you is this, pseudo electronic gas configuration, by pseudo electronic gas configuration, I mean 18 electrons, see 2, 6 and 10. So, it has 18 electrons in its outermost shell, okay? So, these 18 electrons are similar to the octet in a real inert gas. Okay, these are similar to the octet. What is the reason here is this, see it has d orbital involved. D orbital has, you must have studied this, very poor screening effect. So very poor screening effect, what it will do? So if it has, let's say this is the nuclei, okay, and d orbital has very poor screening effect, so what will happen? This will polarize anything more strongly, okay. So this will polarize the nuclei, will, because of this what will happen, nuclei will polarize any electron cloud present near it more strongly. So that will lead us to a greater amount of covalent character. See, because d orbitals are very diffused, okay, so they are not localized, they are very diffused, so they have less effect on nuclei, that is called they have very poor screening effect. So nuclei is free to attract the electrons, any electron cloud which is present nearby. So electron cloud of chloride ion is polarized more strongly in CuCl than in NaCl, although both of them have same amount of charge and same size of same radius, right. So what happens is they have same amount of charge, same amount of size, still this is more covalent than NaCl, and which is reflected by melting point data, okay. So which is reflected by melting point data. So whenever any atom is such that it has a pseudo inert gas electronic configuration, what happens is this, they have a greater amount of covalent character and hence they have a lower amount of melting point. Okay, so here I'll rest my discussion of Fajan's rule and melting point description. What we'll start now is we'll see the how Fajan's rule can be applicable or applications of Fajan's rule in many other properties. Okay, so let's start with the discussion.
Okay, so what we have seen, Fajan's rule, polarizing power and polarizability, the covalent character, basically the covalent character, how you determine the covalent character in a compound. Okay, now let's see the application. What happens with the more covalent character? So if I ask you lithium plus and sodium plus, okay, just tell me which, just try to look at which of these ions have the greater polarizing power. Okay, so greater polarizing power, obviously this. Why? Because the same charge, but it has a smaller in size, it is smaller in size. Okay, so if I am taking two molecules, lithium iodide and sodium iodide, what will happen? Which of these molecules has more covalent character? This, because it has greater polarizing power. Okay, so what is happening with the covalent characters? See, as covalent character in a molecule will increase, what will happen? The molecule solubility will decrease, solubility in polar solvents, right? Molecule solubility in polar solvents decreases, okay, because covalent molecules, the covalent molecules are more soluble in non-polar solvents. The same rule, like dissolves like. So what will happen? Solubility will decrease as more and more covalent character increases. Okay, so what we can do is we can just try to summarize this thing. Okay, let's try for the cations first. Okay, so I am taking group 1 cations, I mean down the group, and then cations along one period. Okay, so let's say I am taking sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium. Okay, so if I am using these set of cations, what will happen? Polarizing power of these cations is decreasing down the group. So polarizing power, so what I am doing now is I am talking about polarizing power. Okay, so polarizing power will decrease down the group, will decrease. Why? Because of the size, because increase in size, right? So size is increasing, so polarizing power is decreasing, right? If I go along this thing, the period, so lithium plus beryllium plus 2, boron plus 3, carbon plus 4, phosphorus plus nitrogen plus 5. See what, why I am giving this much charge? Because I want them to be isoelectronic, okay? Then only I can compare. So what I want them to be isoelectronic. So what will happen as we are moving along the period, the charge is increasing, and you remember charge is the major factor in deciding hydrogen energy, lattice energy, and as well as in the polarizing power. Anyway, because the charge is increasing, okay, and these are isoelectronic species, the size will be lowest in this case. That means size will decrease this way, right? So size will decrease it this way, that means polarizing power will increase. Polarizing power will increase as we go along the period when the species are isoelectronic. Okay, don't remember, this species should be isoelectronic. So polarizing power will decrease because of decrease in size. Okay, so if let's talk about anions. So if I'm talking about anions, okay, so I will have to talk about what? The property of the anions, that is polarizability. Okay, so I am taking polarizability thing here. I am going down the group and then again along one period. Okay, so down the group, say I am taking fluorine, bromine, and iodine. That means fluoride, chloride, bromide, and iodide ions, right? So what is happening? Size is increasing, and polarizability is directly proportional to size. Remember, here the trend is different. So polarizability is directly proportional to the size. So what will happen? Polarizability will increase. Polarizability will increase, right? And if I go this way, that means I am taking, say, boron, carbon, and then nitrogen, and then phosphorus, okay, nitrogen, that is minus 3, say minus 4, do not go here, just because this is very high, this has to be very high in charge, so forget this thing, nitrogen, and then after oxygen and this thing, right? Okay, so what will happen, because see, for every extra electron you add, okay, size increases to a great extent. So what will happen? Size will be highest in this, and then in this, and then in this. So polarizability will what? Decrease as you go along the period. Along the period. And again, these species are isoelectronic here. Okay, so you can remember this trend. So let's talk about some questions. See, what are the effects of polarizing this thing, Fajan's rule, the covalent character. As covalent character will increase, solubility will decrease. That's in polar solvents, right? Remember the polar solvents. So that is one of the consequences. The other consequence is melting point, boiling point, okay? Everything will decrease because the ionic compounds, in ionic compounds, ions are bonded together by strong electrostatic interactions, and when they are losing some part of their electrostatic interactions, that means when the covalent character is developed here, the melting point and the boiling point will decrease because the force is not that strong as it was in the previous case. Okay, so let's talk about melting points. What is the trend of melting points? So if I'm taking, say, NaCl, KCl, okay, this thing, so what will happen? What do you see here? The covalent character is, what is happening? See, anion is same, right? Anion is same, cation, the charge is same, but the size is increasing in this direction. That means this has the most amount of covalent characters, right? So if I write the covalent character, this has the most amount of covalent character, then this species, and then this species. So what will happen? Melting point is will decrease. So melting point order, if I ask you what will be the melting point order, KCl and RBCl, so melting point will decrease. That means it has greater amount of covalent character, so it has a smaller melting point than this thing, right? Yeah, good. So it will have a smaller amount of melting point because the greater covalent character. Okay, so next, if I ask you SnCl2, SnCl4, okay, which has the more melting point, which of this compound has more melting point? Okay, see here +4 charge, here +2 charge, right? So +4, that means higher covalent character. Higher covalent character means lower melting point, right? So melting point will be like this. GeCl2, GeCl4, right? Again, +2 and +4. So this thing will happen, right? If I ask you about SnCl2 and SnCl4, the trend will be same. All these are carbon family members, right? Germanium, tin. Oh, I wrote tin 2 times, sorry. Okay, so it can be lead. You can write it as lead, right? So all these are carbon family members, right? So this can be the melting point. See here, I compared on the basis of charge. You can also compare on the basis of size, right? Like here I did. So beryllium chloride, magnesium chloride, okay, calcium, strontium and barium. So their chlorides. So what will happen? So this is the smallest in size and charge is same and on everything. So what will happen? This has the greater amount of covalent character, that means greater covalent character, that means lower melting point, right? Greater covalent character means lower melting point. So melting point will decrease, right? So these are the trends for melting points, right? This is for melting point, this is also for melting point. I have written all this for melting point, okay? So greater the covalent character, smaller is the melting point of these compounds.